Test 1 2. Test 1 2. This is Frank. Test 1 2. Missy, go, 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 at me, go.
Ovaries, ovaries, ovaries.
What? Okay, that's a great test for Christian. Mike.
Wow.
Missy is mad at Frank.
Welcome, ICP fans, to another episode. Why am I in lowdown for the showdown mode? Oh, okay. Welcome, ICP. Why can't I say P? Welcome, ICP fans, to another episode of the end. Welcome, ICP fans. Welcome, ICP. Welcome, ICP fans, to another episode of. What the?
We're about to do it again.
How do I start this show?
Missy, do you want to take over here?
Welcome, ICP fans, to the 150th straight week we've done this freaking show. What's up, Missy?
Oh, hello, hello.
Hey, Christian.
Good evening.
And, Mike.
Hola.
Happy to have you guys here on a special occasion. 150th. Straight week.
Hey, congratulations to you guys, man, and honored to be here for that.
Thank you. And we are honored to have you guys on. Well, Mike, you're stuck here for a while.
I'm not in the honored guest category.
No, you're a worker bee for free. You're like an intern almost, but there's no college credits given. Sorry.
Just real life experience, you know. No, but man, 150 episodes is not easy to do consecutively. So kudos to your consistency, your determination, your dedication to the show, and bringing a great broadcast to the fans. I salute you.
Thank you, Christian.
What he said.
Missy, did that make you feel all good inside?
Yeah, all warm and tingly.
Ooh. Tell us more. What else are you feeling?
Uncomfortable.
creeped out.
Yeah.
So Missy, how was the F1 race this weekend? What was the no for? What did you think I was going to say? What's on your... Your mind's in the gutter, girl.
Well, Max Verstappen won.
Yes, he did. Old limpet lips. You know,
he made a nice pass early in the race.
Incredible Mr. Limpet,
and then...
right? Remember that? The incredible Mr. Limpet. Has anybody else seen that?
No.
You lost me on that one.
Come on, really? Out of the four of us, I'm the only one that saw the incredible Mr. Limpet.
Yeah, man.
And Ladyfish? Come on, really? Oh, God.
Yep.
Anyway,
I think you mentioning Ladyfish actually made it worse. Like, I didn't know what you were talking about originally,
okay,
but you made it worse.
Okay, so...
Now I really don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, I think his name is Don Knotts. You know who Don Knotts is from the Andy Griffith Show? He was one of the deputies with that weird voice.
Yeah.
Right? Well, he sort of looks like a fish, too. But in the movie, The Incredible Mr. Limpet, he really liked fish. And then he fell into the water, and he became a cartoon fish. And he helped the American forces beat the Nazis by telling... the submarines where the other submarines were, by making some weird sound. And he met Ladyfish and fell in love with Ladyfish. And there was a crab, too. Yep, and he was all crabby. Get it? Because he was a crab. He was crabby.
Oh, this show's going downhill fast.
But I'm saying Verstappen looks like the incredible Mr. Limpet. That's what I'm saying. Limpet lip.
To be on. So, yeah, Max Verstappen won this race, followed by Lewis Hamilton. I'm
going to
keep talking over you because nobody cares about Mr. Limpet.
I'm talking about. Please DM me and you'll win something that I have signed from somebody. I don't know. Please back me up.
No, anyway, Max Verstappen won, followed by Lewis Hamilton and Daniel Ricciardo to round out your podium. And you had Sebastian Vettel, Valtteri Bottas, Sergio Perez, Stoffel Van Dorn, Lance Stroll, Felipe Massa, Esteban Ocon for your top 10. And you had Fernando Alonso, Kevin Magnussen, Romain Grosjean, Pierre Gasly, Julian Palmer, Nico Hülkenberg, Pascal Whelan, Marcus Ericsson, Carlos Sainz, and Kimi Räikkönen, who didn't start.
Why didn't he start?
It's some sort of turbocharger issue from what I read.
Yeah. Well, I thought a couple cars were having DRS issues too, so I don't know.
Well, they interviewed him, but listening to him being interviewed is like, I don't know, being like Chinese water tortured. Something like that. Like, you know, where it drips on your head.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, you don't retain much information during that. You just know it's very it's just unpleasant. That's a Kimi Räikkönen in an interview. Wow. Oh boy. I should really edit this show. Yep. Everybody stay silent to make it even more worse.
Yep.
I guess
your championship standings right now. Lewis Hamilton is still leading with 281 points. Then you have Sebastian Vettel with 247. I guess you can throw Valtteri Bottas in there with 222 points. With how many races are left to go?
Five.
Well, they're in COTA soon, right? Next, I think. Are they?
No, yes, they're in Japan next.
Suzuka?
Oh, wait, Japan. No. Oh, yeah, Japan this weekend. Yeah.
I think COTA is the beginning of November.
Oh, I thought... Oh, that's right.
No. Yes, okay. COTA is October 20th to the 22nd.
And then it's Mexico City.
And Japan is next this weekend coming up.
So that's...
Then you have Mexico,
Suzuka,
after
right?
COTA, and then Brazil and Abu Dhabi in the end of November.
This is where that iconic photo was taken last year of Nico Rosberg making the turn into turn one at Suzuka with the car fully loaded. That was an awesome picture. Come on, I'm not alone on this one, right? Seriously? Anybody?
Seen it? It was all right.
Okay, I thought it was awesome. It went viral, didn't it?
Yeah.
Well, there you go. All right. So anyway, moving on. Verstappen won on his birthday.
That's right.
All day after, but yeah.
And Ricardo got third. Did he do the shoey thing?
No, he didn't.
Well, that's good. Right?
I guess.
I like that guy.
Have to suffer drinking it.
Well, yeah, no, yeah. He's cool. It's just disgusting. He's
gotta... Oh, no, for sure. But I do like that he adds a lot of personality to the sport. And I appreciate the guys like that, that kind of mix it up, show a little bit more of who they are outside of the car. So I definitely enjoy watching it.
Name two more Formula One drivers like him.
Yeah, just him, man.
Yeah,
I mean, exactly. Lewis is kind of out there too, just to be personality wise as well. But
not really.
But nobody like Ricardo. No, no.
No, no. See, it's everything you see of him is just stock footage of him doing things. He's not talking to a camera or anything. It's just him doing things, and I'm like, this is why. Like, why? Why am I watching this? I don't care if he skateboards down the street. Do you?
Nope, not at all.
No. It's not something I wake up and think, oh, I wonder what, you know, Daniel Ricciardo is doing right now. But I just like to see people who aren't cookie cutter. That's what I'm meaning to say.
Well, Ricciardo definitely is his own person. Yeah. I'll give him that.
I think it's thanks he didn't do the shoey this week. I enjoyed seeing who was going to drink out of the shoe.
You wanted to see it?
Yeah. I want to see who's going to drink out of the shoe.
Maybe he won't do it in third, just second or first. I don't know. Is there some sort of...
I think he said he really didn't want to do it every time, but then I think the one race, somebody, whoever was the announcer was, requested the drink out of a shoe, so then he did it, and then, you know.
Oh, that's disgusting.
See, I gotta come then, up with something like
and then
that.
The young kid, Lance
like
Stroll, got his first podium, so he had to drink out of the shoe, you know, his first podium.
Right. Yeah, see, I gotta get something going like that.
Well, that's what Anthony Martin said. Like, he'll do it his first win, but that's about it. He won't do it again. That's what he said, anyway. I think he was lying. He'll do it every time.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... There you go.
Yeah, that was Formula One. Again, Suzuka's this weekend, so check your local listings, because
good luck. Yeah, Japan, I don't have a clue what, you know, how far behind the Eastern they are. I have no idea.
Probably whatever time it is there, it's probably the same time here, but day or whatever, you know, vice versa.
Close
night time,
it,
whatever.
Yeah. Within 2 to 3 hours at least. So, I guess, yeah, I don't know. I did manage to catch the qualifying at, like, 4:30 in the morning. I don't know why, but I did. Well, not really. I turned it on, and then I passed out. So, I didn't watch it. But it was on the TV.
They're 13 hours ahead. I just looked it up.
There you go. Suzuka is one of my favorite, tracks on iRacing. Really, you know, I mean, if you can hit those three S's right there after turn one, like perfectly, you can really gap the field, man. If you're in first,
what car were you running it in?
Pro Mazda.
Okay, yeah, all right.
Huh?
I have to check it out. I'll have to check it out. I haven't driven Suzuka yet in the PM, but I'll get on there with you sometime.
Well, I mean, once you drive it, you'll really appreciate the fact of that picture that guy caught in the turn one, and you'll see why. I'm like, when I see it, I go, wow, look at that. And people are like, what? Like, it's just a crashed car. I'm like, no, it's not. It's not crashed at all. But that's what it looks like. Anyway. I don't know. I mean, is with the last couple races, is Hamilton going to lose this championship or no?
I don't think so.
I say he wins it.
I mean, does Vettel have anything for him in the next couple of races? Does Ferrari have the edge? Does Mercedes have the edge? Does Renault have the edge? All of a sudden, Renault, well, Red Bull anyway, with the Tag Heuer engine in it. Yeah.
I was reading some stat the other day about their, I guess the body work, the body kit that they had was the most efficient, I guess they claimed, that Red Bull team. So that's got to give some advantage somewhere, but if...
I'll tell you what, man, like, they were going over why the 2017 Mercedes was so much faster than, you know, everybody else. And it was because of these two little U-shaped carbon fiber-like inlets on the back, you know, rake of the car. And what it did was funneled the... funneled some sort of airflow away from something and behind it, and that added like 200 or 300 more pounds of downforce on the rear, and yeah, that's why they chewed up tires, but they were faster because of it, so because they could take the corners faster, and it was all because of these two little like 5-inch long by like 3-inch wide pieces of U-shaped carbon fiber. It's crazy. That was the only reason. Things, yeah, it was insane how really aerodynamic these cars are, and like when pieces come flying off of them, that's a really big deal.
You're right. Yeah, absolutely, man. It's but you really do appreciate the ingenuity that goes into it. And you know, those slight little tweaks that just make all the difference in the world.
But I mean, it just further shows you how really insignificant the driver really is with these cars nowadays. He's just a part of the car that does what it's supposed to do, and as long as he does that, the car is going to do what it can. You know what I mean? So the driver's it's all about the car, really. I mean, that's what it comes down to. You know, which car is better, which car has more, the best aerodynamics on it for whatever, you know, they're going through. And it's just crazy how that's all it takes. You know, if you're in a Sauber ride, you're not winning the championship. Sorry. It's just not going to happen. So, you know, hey, you made the show, but you're just a spectator like the rest of us, really. You just got better seats.
they're just paying for a better seat.
Mm-hmm. That's it. You know, they're just happy to be there. Yeah. But Force India, I think Force India got a lot better since the beginning of the year. I'll give them that. You know, they're always in the top 10 now. All of a sudden, they never used to be that.
And yeah, well, they're not crashing into each other.
But doesn't Force India have Mercedes engines? Or do they have Ferrari engines? I think it's Mercedes.
I don't remember.
Who really cares, actually? I mean, does anybody?
Not particularly.
No, me neither. Mm-mm. Okay, so let's move on. So that's F1. The exciting world of F1. Yes. Yep, that's going to give us the hard cards right there, Missy. Alright.
By the way, that was their last time in Malaysia. I guess we should mention that.
Oh, yeah. We'll never see that track again. Yeah. Another racing series that's, slowly dying. Losing tracks left and right. What is this now? Let's see, Nürburgring's gone. What other track's gone now? I haven't seen them in Brazil and Interlagos. Were they there this year?
They will be November 10th through the 12th.
Oh, well, there you go. Okay. So they're still there. All right. They're about to be out of Coda.
Wait a minute. Wait, you said Interlagos? No, is that Sao Paulo? That same track?
No, it's Interlagos is a different part of Brazil.
Then
Sao Paulo is a street circuit, I think.
Then no, they didn't go there.
So they're not going to Interlagos anymore?
No. They just have on here Brazil, Sao Paulo. November 10th through the 12th.
Can you click on the track or anything?
I did. I just told you Sao Paulo.
No, like what Formula the track looks 1, like.
Grand. Yeah, I can click on it and see what it looks like.
Well, does it look like a street circuit, or does it look like a road circuit?
Really?
I'm just wondering if it's South, if it's Interlagos or if it's a street circuit.
Sure, it looks like both. The track layout looks like both.
Is it
The
really
circuit could
tight
be a
90s or is it a bunch
road.
of sweeping turns? Jeez Louise. Oh.
It's got some sweeping turns in there. It's got some straight lines too.
Oh my God.
Ladies and gentlemen.
If you show me Baltimore, I'd be able to pick it out because it looks like a street circuit. If you showed me
Oh, I'm
Barber,
sorry.
I'd be like,
I don't
that's not a
stare
street circuit. That's
really
got to be a
want
road
to.
circuit. I'm just never mind. Moving on. Who knows? I don't know. Yeah. So, but yeah, Coda's about to be gone. I heard that. You think it'll be the last year for Coda, or will they come back?
I think they'll be back.
Yeah, I could see one more year.
They sell out and they still lose a profit.
Money.
You believe that? And that's a big
How? I
track.
mean, how's that possible?
Probably F1
That is
sanctioning
a,
fees.
Because the sanctioning
yeah, the
fee to
sanction
have
fees are
the event
ridiculous.
is so high, it's insane.
That's why tickets are so expensive and I won't go. I'm like,
And that's
looked
why,
into it and I
like,
was like, whoa, that's for the lawn seat? Holy crap.
you know, and then, like,
Is that
it's.
grass made out of gold that I'm going to be sitting on?
Nope. It's going to be probably wet and soggy with worms and ants. Creepy crawlies. Probably fire ants for me. No doubt about it. Yeah, I mean, like, and they have zones too, on how closer you can get to the cars and everything. And you go through gates, and each one's like another $500. Next one's 1,000. It's ridiculous. They have zones you can buy to get closer. So you might get a snapshot with your camera through a fence if you pay enough.
If you pay enough, right?
If you pay enough, of course.
Mm-mm.
Now, I mean, that's what they did in Singapore, which I think might be the last time they go there too. I don't know. I heard. I'm not sure if that's true or not. Cash, let me know after you hear this. Thank you. All right. Yeah. I think. Yeah. I think that's it for F1. Yep. So, yeah.
Yeah, I mean there wasn't too much. I mean it's going to be a slow weeks coming up.
Oh, they're just
Yeah,
going
I
to get
guess the only one.
slower. I can't believe Foyt has not announced drivers yet. He was the
I
first one to
read.
say that we're going to announce as soon as possible. It could be before, they take the podiums at Sonoma.
I'm
And
going to be making a prediction that they'll be making the announcement on Thursday.
are you
You
saying,
read that. I
is he
read
re
that same tweet.
I seen that too,
I don't know. I plead the fifth.
Way to go,
Yes,
plagiarist.
Thursday the announcement's going to be made.
Mike's, what do you call that? I don't know what that's called.
Cheater.
No, because what did you? I guess so. Well, no, I, yeah, I don't know. I don't know what you call it. Yeah, but in radio, what, rip off? Yeah, you're a rip off. That's yeah.
It's fine.
Definitely can't think. You can definitely
He's
can't
been
think.
called worse and been happier.
You can't think for yourself, that's for sure. I'm kidding. Oh, that was actually mean. I'm sorry. I was just kidding.
Yeah, the plan to announce the driver of the number 14 car on Thursday.
Who's it going to be, everybody?
Which fourth? That would be Carlos Munoz's car
It
from
is.
this year. 14?
It
Yeah.
was. It was.
It's
Or
Connor
is.
Daly drove the four.
Right. So I guess that's two. I mean. Will they be announcing TK, or do they do that already?
Officially done that.
Well,
They haven't,
I would
right?
assume it's unofficial. They said TK, but
Yeah, unofficially, but
I guess no for definite Thursday.
so I guess Munoz, will be the one. Well, that doesn't mean anything, really.
No.
It just means, you know, I mean, you know, Munoz can still go to the four, you know. Just saying. But, you know, I guess...
There was an article on IndyCar.com that came out that Connor Daly feels like they made progress towards the end of the season. So, I mean, and he wants to continue with AJ Foyt Racing.
Of course he says that, because he looks up and down.
Hey, whatever keeps you your job.
He said, this is the last team that I could actually replace that. I'm going to say everything I can.
I guess it's all off-season stuff. You say the right things, whatever, you know. We're talking to different teams, you know. Oh, yeah. We're close to a deal with, you know, certain teams.
Winning
the
teams.
The normal
we're off-season. Winning teams, remember. Winning teams. Yeah, we're talking to a few winning teams, you know, teams that win. Well, so in IndyCar, that's everyone but Foyt, okay.
Narrows it down a little bit.
Yeah.
But there was an article that came out where they interviewed Mark Miles. I think it was the Indy Star wrote the article. Okay. And they did, you know, mention that they were trying to have a 22-car grid next year.
I did see that. He mentioned, like, three new teams or something?
Yes. Yeah, and they would be Carlin, Junkos, and Harding. And each of them they had listed as a one-car effort, so.
Which, I was very surprised to see that.
How do you guys feel about one-car teams?
I think you need.
I mean, are they good for the sport? Are they bad for it, or what?
Well, for the Indy 500, sure, but not for a season. What Ray Hall managed to do with one car was pretty amazing, because no other one car team's been able to do that.
But is it?
Yeah,
it's
not easy to do.
You know, maybe for their first years they kind of learn the ropes, but I think long term success, you need two cars.
You need more than two, really. Yeah. I mean, for long term,
it's a bounce off.
Minimum.
Three or four.
Feedback.
I mean,
and
look at Andretti. Yeah, exactly. Messy feedback. The more feedback, the better. To find solutions that might take us to a more amazing place. What is that?
Oops. My bad. Sorry.
What are you watching?
Indy Star. I came up on the Indy Star when I was trying to pull up the article.
Nice.
Got commercials on the internet. I mean, you can't get away from them.
Well, you know, they gotta, you know, make money somehow.
And shout out to DeVry, the fine institution.
And shout out to Amazon, too. Hey, Christian, do you know how I found your book?
How'd you find my book?
Through your website.
Okay.
No, I'm sorry.
Well, I'm
it was
well,
through.
I'm glad you found.
Well, you don't have a website.
Is this where we're about to do the Twitter thing? Is this how you're about to?
Yeah, I found it. I found it through Twitter. It was a, you know, I saw Alessio Racing post that his book was now available on Amazon, and I retweeted it and I bought the book. So do you see how Twitter works, man? That's awesome.
Well, thank you. You know, I've been on that thing constantly, all day, every day.
You haven't
just took a break for it to do this show. I just took a break from Twitter now just to do the show.
You haven't downloaded the app yet, have
you? I
sense
some sarcasm.
He hasn't downloaded the freaking app yet, have you? No, you haven't, because your bio is still empty. I'm about to write it. I'm not even joking. I'm about to write
do
it.
Not. No, do not.
I told you.
ISCP fans, Frank, I do not give Frank permission to write my bio.
I haven't done anything
all right,
with
fans,
that.
Keep him accountable.
I haven't done anything with that Twitter but put two pictures up.
Uh-huh.
A picture of the book.
Well, I'm saying it over the air, though, so the fans can keep you accountable.
Hey, but you have 20 followers now, by the way.
What's that?
Well,
okay.
Yeah, I just looked. You have 20 followers. I didn't
closing in on you know, closing in on the rock. Yep.
Well, I mean,
closing in on The Rock now.
You're following 400.
Oh, really?
Well, they're all drivers though. They're all verified drivers. You know, you're following all your buddies.
Plus us. I mean, that's the most exciting part.
Your entire fantasy football team you're following.
Okay.
You know, racers like that.
Yeah, I got you. I got Spencer this week. We'll see how that goes.
Rock on. All right.
So I thought there was an interesting article put out by IndyCar too. Again, they talk about the new media and new audiences, and they pretty much dropped their numbers from 2016 compared to this year. So it was a big step forward this year with ratings on TV, Facebook that seemed to skyrocket their numbers, Twitter engagements. I mean.
Yep.
IndyCar fans are getting more involved, and I think with Joseph Newgarden winning the championship this year, I think it helped a lot to bring in that younger fan base, because he's only 26. I mean, so, and I think, you know, they've watched him grow up the past, what, 3-4 years he's been in IndyCar the last couple of years.
Well, since Sarah Fisher, right? 2012 almost, right?
Yep.
2012, yep.
Yeah, so I mean, they've watched him, you know, the past couple of years. So I think that has helped, you know, grow the younger IndyCar fan base with having a younger, you know, driver take the championship this year, and not one of the normals, you know, Will, Scott Dixon, you know, Tony, you know, who wasn't one of the normals that you see at the top of the list every year.
Yeah, I agree that probably attributed a lot to it. And it's good to see. It's good to see it grow, especially when other forms of motorsport are on the decline. Glad to see that our beloved IndyCar is.
All of them, but IndyCar.
Mm-hmm.
You can't name another one that's on the incline.
But that says a lot about the show they're putting on, you know? It's
8.4 million. 300% higher than a year ago. That's great.
Wow.
That's awesome, uh-huh. IndyCar fans. Give yourselves a round of applause. And new media, I love that. You know, we're new media, right? I mean, we are a new form of media that is, you know, pushing the IndyCar series, right? So basically what Missy is saying is this article is basically praising us for making this happen.
That's an interesting way of looking at it, yes. Okay.
Missy, am I close?
Yeah, sure. We'll go with that.
Right on.
Sounds good.
You hear that, ISCP fans? Frank Linker is single-handedly responsible for turning IndyCar around.
Well, there's 7 comments. Let's see what the comments say. I guarantee you it'll back right my claim. Guarantee it. Okay, let's see. First one. IndyCar lists the drivers on Twitter, the teams on Twitter, and the tracks on Twitter. They used to also list the Mazda Road to Indy drivers on Twitter, but no longer do. Big mistake. Uh-oh. Those kids were great to hear from on the ISCP podcast on Twitter. The IndySportsCarPodcast.com, and you get to know them through social media as well. Right on, Marky. See what I mean? Now
on Twitter.
Now, yeah, on Twitter. That's a
gratuitous use of the word Twitter in that
post. No, that entire post is real except for the ICP part. I don't know. Only 3 of us have even commented growth. Really? What? That doesn't make any sense.
These comments are not helping the social media grows IndyCar narrative.
Amy Melton is uninformed. She keeps... Okay, then she put owners. Just owners. As a post. Okay. Great. That's a good post. need sponsorship and more own words. Okay, right on, Amy. Amy is on top, dude. Why is Amy not running the series? I mean, if she was, we would be gold. I mean, we need more sponsorship.
Wait, she more might, own I don't words. Know. Only three of us have commented. She's commented three times already. She's counting her own comments.
Yeah. Listen, math is difficult for some people, guys.
She doesn't know why anybody's commenting. Because there's not. I mean, you said it all, Amy. I mean, you didn't leave anything open for discussion or debate.
I mean, I got it. So there's only three comments on there, but, you know, over 1,000 people have liked it on Twitter or on Facebook alone, so the article. But no growth.
And,
yeah.
And here's Weldon. Okay. Keep up the good work, IndyCar. Right on, Weldon. More cars, more races, longer season. Go IndyCar. I mean, can't argue with that. And then he replied to himself. I love people who reply to themselves. I actually do that too. By the way, a beautiful picture of the starting grid coming around turn four at Indy. The adrenaline in the stands when the cars come around in starting for me. I suck at reading out loud. In starting formation is just unbelievable. Listening to ISCP all week before this race even made the experience that much better because I knew what I was looking at. And I can only imagine what it feels like to the drivers at this point just before the race starts because whoever wins will be on ISCP. I mean, now that is a good post right there.
That, yes, that was...
Weldon... I love good job, Weldon. I mean, right on, Weldon. And then we have Mustang. Great name. Ford sucks. Mustang. Ugh. Just think what could happen if the series was on NBC primetime for the majority races and it was properly promoted. Just imagine. I don't need to. All I have to do is watch races from the 90s and... before, buddy, because that's kind of where they were then. So, imagining not needed, just YouTube. So, but that's not saying that that's where we need to be. He's right. We need to be there. We need to be on primetime, cable networks for every race of the season. None of this jumping around crap. That way, the network can dedicate all the money to IndyCar and the production of its broadcast. You know, I mean, now, look ABC, NBC, which channel got more races, right? I'm not really asking. It's a rhetorical question. Of course, it's NBC Sports Network, right? ABC had how many races? Four, five?
Five total.
Right. And but two of those is the Duel in Detroit, so...
So four. Okay.
Exactly. So, four events out of six...
So you're saying you'd like it there to be just one...
One network, and that way that network can dedicate... See, because NBC had it for the majority. Their product was heads and tails better, and there is a reason. The network spent more money on the product to make the product better because they were paying so much money for it since they had so many races. ABC is not going to give that giant budget to a product they only get four times a year. So that's why we hated ABC and that's why we love NBC. You see what I mean? So no matter what network gets them, it needs to be everything. You know, the 500, everything. And if that happens, then, you know, they'll be able to dedicate more money to it. That's all I'm saying. So, you know,
I wish that the broadcasts were a little more technical, though, to be honest.
They used to be.
just as far as the way the information is presented, I feel it's like a very, it's kind of casual, you know what I mean? It's for like the, you know, anybody could tune in and watch it and kind of figure out what's going on. But I,
well, with these new cars, you know, the technical part of it's kind of going to be right in your face, you know, because the way they look, you can see what everything is, where it is. And it's pretty obvious why it's there, you know? So,
yeah.
With it being so simplified, I think it's going to be that much easier for fans to understand what they're looking at, because you look at the cars that they just were running with, and you're like, I guess it works. It helps. I don't know. You know? But with this new car coming out, it's so simple. I mean, the back wing is so small, it's insane. you know, it's just, am I wrong here? I mean, am I right?
Nope, I'm in complete agreement.
Like you, Mike. Messi? Is Frank right?
No.
You just said no because of that question.
Of course. Why would I answer differently to that question?
Well, what do you think? Honestly, though. Do you agree with Christian?
Sorry, what were we talking about?
Wow. All right, so...
I was saying that that the broadcasts were a little simple. Just as far as the technical information given... anybody can just, you know, kind of tune in and start watching from there. I'd like to see it be a little more technical. Like, I find myself watching some of those Formula E races, and I just really enjoy how in-depth they get with just everything and anything. And I love it. So guys like me who like to watch it and just really learn about every little piece and what it does to affect the overall outcome of the car, I would like to see more of that.
Which car? The one they start with or the one they end with?
Effectively both, but yeah, that's all I'm saying. I just would like to see, you know.
Okay. Well, yeah, I agree. I think I like, you know, I like if they talk a little more technical, but I thought sometimes you know, I do hear them explaining things a little bit more in detail. I think what's it, Paul Tracy, I think, explains stuff a lot.
Jan Beekes has done those videos that have been published, especially about the 2018 car, that are pretty interesting.
Yeah, and he needs to do more. I mean, more during a broadcast.
Yeah,
for sure.
I mean, they only give you, like, one. You know, he needs to do... I want to see, like, 12. Give or take. Yeah. Four? Would four be too many?
I think that's fair.
I don't think so.
Yeah, do four. You know, he's got the time. I see him all the time. Just sits there, does nothing.
He's got the time. Frank knows his schedule. He's got the time.
I've seen him. You know, I went, I ate a burger, I came back, he's still there. Could have done a segment. What are you doing? You know, get that nose on camera and talk about something on the car, man. You know, that's all I'm saying. He's a nice guy, though. Yep.
So... what do you guys think about coming up with a new running order for qualifying for ovals?
What do you mean?
Power and Joseph Newgarden brought it up that, you know, that they want the series to come up with a new system for deciding the running order in qualifying on ovals.
I'm behind it 100%, personally.
Wait, Frank. We didn't even hear what the proposed new method would be.
I didn't either.
You're just jumping on board, but you don't even know. You're jumping on board a question mark. Did they say what the new proposed order would be, Miss?
Power mentioned that he thought maybe they should do it based on oval championship points, because, you know, it'd be unfair to Ed Carpenter, you know, to do overall championship points, since, you know, he's only a oval.
It's insane.
Specialist.
She didn't want to say it.
Missy is cringing right now.
It's insane to change an oval, you know, qualifying anything just because Ed Carpenter only does ovals. They shouldn't make any changes to anything.
I think they said if it was an oval, it would be force him to go first every time.
Why?
Because he only does ovals. Because he's
naturally going to have the lowest points.
Yeah, if you do championship.
Oh, right. Okay, I got you. Right. Mm-hmm.
But the overall premise is, you know, anybody who drives qualifies first through 10th. Automatically is at a disadvantage because of the Pro Mazda rubber laid down or different track temperatures, so some way to even it out so that it's not the same, you know, issues going into every oval. So I think I read, you know, like Missy said, based on season, overall season standings is how they qualified in reverse, which I would be fine with. Listen, if it's Ed Carpenter's first every time, that's what he gets for running ovals.
Yeah, because the guy running last is normally going to get the pole if his car's hooked up. I think I called it a Pocono, didn't I?
You did.
You did say that. Yeah, that was Pocono, yep.
Mm-hmm. I know that. I just wanted to say that and have you guys say that because I like being right every once in a while. It's fun.
Yeah, notice how Missy stays silent.
I didn't ask you.
Yeah, I know you didn't.
Why? Because I didn't care what you have to say.
Oh, is that so? All right.
No, that's not. That's not so. I care. I swear.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you'll agree. Yeah, right. Oh, God.
So we're all in favor then of the new proposed qualifying order.
What is it? Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah, okay. Am I in favor of it? It's funny how the leaders come up with this.
Should make it interesting. They should, you know, do it in groups like they do for street courses. Throw them out. Throw six of them out there and just go. Make qualifying for the ovals a little more interesting.
Yeah, really.
Wow.
I mean, that's what they did. That's what they did for one race, didn't they? Didn't they have like a five lap shootout for the qualifying or for the race grid one time?
Yeah, I think they did. They did mention it. I guess it was the IndyCar experiment with Iowa. Yeah, it was Iowa 2013, and Power said no, he didn't like it. They were terrible. They all just cruised around because they didn't want to risk our cars.
It was boring. It was a line. Nobody would pass anybody because, yeah, exactly. Nobody was trying hard.
So boring. I hardly even remember it happening.
Well, you know, Randy Bernard was the guy that, you know, came from bull riding and didn't know anything about great, you know, cars, especially formula cars. That, you know. Especially a car did he ask anybody, can these cars do a standing stop or a standing start? It's like, you kidding? When these things stop, it's a hold your breath and, you know, I hope it stays running. They're not made to do it. But he just said, well, F1 can, so we should too. It's like, it's okay, yeah, they kind of look the same, but they're not. Anyway.
They throw out a couple different things. I think they have here that Newgarden said that maybe set the running order by flipping the practice speeds, you know, going slowest first, fastest last.
Just draw straws and get over it. Honestly, who cares? Pick a number out of a hat. You know, or yeah, I don't know.
I've done that before, man. It's not, no.
Play bingo then.
Oh, they do that for the 500. Pick a number out of a hat.
I hate it.
Literally, have them play bingo. Why? What's wrong with that? I'd actually watch that. I would watch. Yeah. I would watch bingo. IndyCar bingo.
That would be a very good medium for the new social media initiative.
I love it. I just love it. I mean, would you watch it? I mean, who wouldn't
Put
watch it?
your tire down on your number. Yeah. I see it now, little tires, you
A
know, put them on
giant
your
bingo board. A giant bingo board. I love it. I love it. It.
I can't say I would be all that interested, but it'd probably be pretty funny.
Hey, as long as you know you're watching, that's all that matters. Eyes on the TV, that's what we want. And you know, life-size giant IndyCar bingo. Come on.
Doesn't get much better than that.
And they got to use the red walls. Anyway, but I'd watch it. I mean, I would say IndyCar Jeopardy, but I think it'd be too hard for half of them, especially Newgarden. I don't know. He seems like a it. Never mind. Yeah, he seems like a pretty smart guy. What am I talking about? Forgot Christian was on. Yeah, you only go shopping in malls with them for women's shoes. That's a pretty yeah. But that's all the comments for IndyCar.com. A
Oh, is
lot
that?
had to do with ICP, and I like to see that. I like to see that.
A lot did have to do with that. Absolutely, a lot did have to do with that.
Yeah.
So,
So that's pretty good. Pretty good. I like the picture that they put up there with Rossi. But I guess that's Ed, or I don't know who that is. And I don't know who that is. That Chavez? Who is that?
What are you talking about?
The picture on IndyCar.com for that story you were just talking about.
Yeah, it's Gabby.
Is Gabby? Okay. So who's that? Is that Hildebrand or is that Carpenter? No, wait, it's got the yellow around the roll hoop. Yeah. So who would that be? Who was the rookie he used? Wouldn't be Piggott, right?
No,
I think
Piggott raced for Juncos at the 500.
that's what I thought. So who raced the third car for Carpenter?
there was no third car.
You sure?
Positive.
Okay. Well, would Hildebrand be a rookie?
No.
Yeah, I
I
know.
think it was I think it was Carpenter because Hildebrand had the orange,
Oh, okay.
so I think they must have just used yellow.
Oh, just to differentiate which cars,
I think
quote.
it was yeah.
Because they were identical. It's not like you know, normally like one's kind of white. Anyway, yeah, all right. So right on. So what other news has come out? I mean, you know, no, it's just been a bunch of speculation, really. Nothing concrete.
I just been putting out, I guess articles on different things. Nothing really. I mean, they put out a IndyCar ladder system providing fresh young talent. Because you got Zach Veach, Spencer Piggott with a full time ride. Gabby Chavez, who all came up through the ladder system.
Which is awesome to see. It really is.
If you break it down, Joseph Newgarden came through the ladder system. I mean,
Yep, Hinchcliffe.
Kimball, Munoz. Wait,
Well,
Munoz? The
that's well,
Munoz?
I don't know, but Kimball's a bad example.
He still came up through the ladder system, and even if this is his last, if this was his last year in IndyCar, he
Really
still
hope
had how
so.
many years in IndyCar?
Well, it is. However, it is official. It was made official for Pocono. Will return next year, so that is official. That's something that was you know, came out and was made official since we last talked, because they didn't re-sign right after the race. They wanted to wait and.
Wait a minute, since when? Last year they had like a 2 year extension.
Wait,
They
last year
did.
wasn't the second year of that extension.
No, because last year a bunch of tracks came out with 2 year extensions because it was like Iowa. You had Watkins Glen that announced it. You had Road America that announced it before the race, and Pocono was another one.
Okay, well then this story is Like, I don't know why they wrote the story then.
I think they were just announcing, because it wasn't official of what weekend it was next year, but it came out that it was the 18th and 19th, I believe.
Yes, August 18th and 19th. So it'll be in the middle of August, which it's in the Poconos, so it's a lot cooler up there. You know, normally, as long as it's not pouring out, it's beautiful there. Yep. You know, yeah, they have tables in you know where you eat. That's like made out of a tire. It's pretty cool. It's like a glass countertop on top of a tire. Yep. FYI.
Thank you.
You're welcome. That's what I'm here for. Worthless information. So, Christian.
Yeah, bud.
Any news or headway as far as a seat next year? Anything that you can report on?
Man, I'm working. Just about as hard as I can. My focus has been more on the getting these road courses down and the physical aspect of it for next year. But obviously, my team has been in some good talks. I'm going to be cliche. We're talking to a lot of good teams, a lot of winning teams. that could win, and no. So we've got some beads on a few things. Hopefully something to announce officially coming up pretty soon. Just keep plugging away, man. I just keep plugging away. Energizer Bunny status.
You need to.
I keep going and going and going and going.
You know what would help with that is an active Twitter account.
Yep. Or at least a bio.
It's coming. It's coming, Frank. It's coming, man. I just been it's been busy, man. It's been busy with
You gotta tell me about busy, brother.
Lots of stuff going on in Indy. So
busy's my middle name. Didn't you know that?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, because in high school I was voted boy most likely to be very busy. So.
Did they feel bad for you and just add that award in there?
Yeah, but that wasn't there. Someone voted it in pen. Like,
hey, that's what's in the yearbook. I mean, I never got a ballot, but whatever. They were right.
There you go.
I'm always busy. So, and, all right. 150 weeks. I cannot believe we have done this. There was one or two weeks where we played a episode from, you know, the archives, because, hey, life's life, right? But we still always make sure that we have at least something new to listen to, not something cool to listen to, and something fun to listen to in the racing world of IndyCar and MRTI and F1 and, you know, well, that's about it. Sports car sometimes when it's relevant, and never the N-word. So, you know, and I just want to thank Christian and Mike for coming on, and Messi. This has been, I can't believe we've done 150 weeks, Messi.
Yep.
So
I guess we made it.
I mean, I guess. Yeah, you did. I guess, you know, if you've been listening and you're on the fence, are these guys going to stick around? Because I hate, you know, when things just kind of cease to exist, and, you know, it's like I wasted my time. We're not going anywhere. We've been here this long. If we leave now, it's a whole lot of time wasted, isn't it? So, you know.
Mm-hmm. Very well said.
You know, if anything, I think Missy and I, and, you know, I think, you know, have Mike and Christian on a bunch of times, which is awesome. You know, always have some great conversations. You know, I just have a new, I don't know, passion for doing this, and doing it better and better than, you know, that we can, and, bringing you more and more information that we possibly can. And I think having, Missy freed up a little bit because of Mike taking over some things, that Missy's going to be able to really bring some more just of that goodness that she brought, like this show that she brought, you know? So, and I'm loving it. I'm loving it when Missy's talking, because it's it gives me a break, and she always comes out with some really good stuff.
Yes, she does.
So Missy, come on, Foyt, who's it going to be?
Foyt? Well, I'm gonna go with Tony Kanaan because I just can't see that not happening after it was announced. I mean,
So is it going to be TK and Connor Daly or TK and Munoz?
or neither,
Or neither.
or neither,
Ah,
neither, neither or neither. How do you say, Christian?
either.
It's neither.
Either is acceptable.
Either or either's acceptable?
Yes, either, neither, neither is acceptable.
Well, that's funny. So, what do you say, Missy?
I would like to see Munoz there.
Okay, you would like to see Munoz there. What do you think's going to happen?
Don't know.
Wow. You can't like something, and then when you're asked who you think is, never mind. God bless you.
I would like to see Carlos Munoz there over Connor Daly. Period.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. Fair enough.
I mean, I can understand what Connor, I guess, does for the sport. He puts himself out there, his face is out there, his big chin's out there, whatever you want to look at. But I just,
Look, we
I'm
like
not a fan of his
Connor.
racecraft, I guess. I don't know. I don't know.
If you go on YouTube, we have an interview with Connor in the rain at Watkins Glen. He's a good guy, all right?
Yeah, I know. I'm not saying that he's not a good guy. I'm just saying, you asked me who I want to see at Foyt.
I know.
I just told you that's who I would like to see at Foyt. Connor
No,
can go to another team.
I am saying
He could probably
things.
go Chip Ganassi for all I know.
I'm saying things to preempt, messages from people. You know, it's all a little bit of a, PR, thing. Save people time. Sending me messages about Connor Daly. Mike, I heard you were having some messages with about Connor Daly the other day.
A few people. Yes. So I'm going to sidestep that and go with what I think is going to happen. And what I think is going to happen is going to be TK and Connor Daly. I don't really know if I have a, personal or fan opinion if it's Daly or Munoz with TK or neither, but gut feeling in me says it'll be Daly.
Okay. How about you, Christian?
I'm kind of split. I think it's going to be TK and Connor Daly, but I would like to see Munoz. So I agree with Missy, but I also think that it's probably going to be Connor, just with the strong push he made toward the end of the season. Seems like the smarter decision to go with. Although I think overall, I'd say Carlos is probably the better driver in different equipment.
Very well put. That was perfectly put there, Christian. I applaud you.
Thank you. Judges, judges,
I
10, 10, 10,
I
10s across
I applaud
the
you by saying something but really saying nothing at all. That was
board. At all
brilliant.
at the
That was
same time,
brilliant.
right?
I don't know if anybody else caught on to that, but that was so PC, I want to throw up.
Thank you.
I'm kidding, I'm kidding.
I'm running for mayor. I'm running for mayor.
I'm
Shaking
constantly,
hands, kissing babies.
I
That's
am,
me.
I'm, con I'm constantly throwing loaded questions at you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you are. Yeah, you are.
It's almost like a thing that I have to do. It's almost a bit. Like, I'm trying.
I'm gonna give you a list, actually. I'm gonna actually type you up a list of topics to stay away from with me.
That would be great.
And that way we
so so Frank can ignore it and ask the questions anyway.
No, I anyway, will not basically. Ignore that list. I will go off of that list. I will copy it and pass it out to Missy and Mike as well, and all the fans too.
It's like, so they can the show will be nothing but the list. The
we'll just rename it. How to sink Christian's career through radio. But anyway, but no, let's play how we can, you know, make Christian's career possible through radio. And where can they get the book at, Christian?
Absolutely. You can get that on Amazon.com at the moment. I will soon have the link for you guys to get it on Barnes & Noble as well.
And
Books
our
a Million.
Website.
Thrill.Let's do. And your website as well. It's My Life and Story.
Yeah, make sure you send me a link that we can post up on the website. So,
we'll do.
And it'll like be through Amazon. And if you buy it through Amazon, we get a little bit, you know, jingle change to keep the lights on in the studio here. That'd be so funny if like I just did that, you know, and then called up Amazon like I've been doing it. You know, so where's my money? We never sanctioned that.
I love it.
Either way, buy his book. I did. You know?
Yes, you did.
That's right.
My Life and Story, The Outside Group. And
I can't wait.
Hope everybody enjoys it. It's been
forwarded
a hell of a
by
day. Mr. Willie T. Ribbs.
That's right.
Yeah, Willie T. Ribbs, racing legend. Been just a huge inspiration to me personally prior to meeting him and prior to working on this and then having him come on board with this and just give me the amount of encouragement that he has been it's been huge for me anyway.
It's been what?
I actually have a screenshot of one of our text messages as my screensaver on my phone.
Oh, nice.
And just always reminds me when I turn the phone on, keep going, keep pushing, you know. So
I need that. I need that wallpaper because I need a, you know, turn on my phone and like inspirational encouragement to keep going. You know, just one more life.
Are you trying to get to the 500 too?
No, I'm just trying to, you know, get through work faster. You know,
I'm just trying to get to work faster.
Because it's been getting boring, man. It's been getting hard. I mean, there's only so many light bulbs you can replace before you just don't want to see light. You know, you want to live by candlelight, but anymore, I swear. I love the dark.
You want to be Amish now? Okay, I got you.
They got it going on. Although, I wouldn't have a career if I was Amish, I don't think.
That's true.
Yeah, well, but I do buy a lot of their goods in a, you know, store that has electricity, so I never got that, but whatever. But their pretzels are awesome. Those hairy lipped women can make a pretzel, can't they, Mike?
You know, I'm gonna stay at it. I'm gonna leave that one to you.
I'm sorry, just because you don't use electricity doesn't mean you can't use a freaking razor. I mean, shave.
Alright. And on that
you got
note,
a mirror?
Gone. And on that note, you know that I know that Frank
is
Christian, Mike, they all know. Here's to 150 more, you know.
Yes, 150 more. Cheers.